If you're ready to strangle the bejesus out of Power Director because it says your drive is full, no worries. You can free up disk space so you can produce your video. And I'm going to show you how to get her done. Let's make something bigger. We're here on the produce screen. Near the bottom, there's a pie chart that gives you information about the disk that you're writing to and your project. Green is free space on the disk. Blue is used space on the disk. Green and blue should add up to the total disk space of your hard drive. Once you start producing your video, you'll see that the numbers for the additional colors begin to change. Pink is the space required to finish the video. White is how much of the video has been produced. Pink and white should add up to the total size of your video. If you see a lot of blue here and PowerDirector tells you there isn't enough space to produce your video, there's a few things that you can do to free up some space. The first thing that you can do is remove temporary files. A temporary file is a file created to hold information while a file is being created or modified. They store and move data, manage settings, and they help recover lost data. If you want to remove your temporary file to free up some space, you want to go up here to Preferences. And then you want to go to Media Cache. And here you want to click on Manually Delete. Now here in the middle, it shows what type of file it is. And it shows where the file is on your drive. Here on the left, it shows the source file, the original file that the shadow file was created from. And here it shows you the file size. So if you just want to go ahead and clear all this out to free up some space, you can click on Select All. And then you can click on Delete Selected Files. You want to go ahead and click on OK. If there are any files in use right now, it'll go ahead and tell you that. Click on OK again. And once it's done, you can go ahead and close out the interface and click on OK. If you're an experienced user and you want to go to the location of the temp files and delete any additional files, you can go there by clicking on the File Explorer. You want to go to your C drive. You want to go to Users. Go to your name. You want to go to App Data. Roaming. See Cyberlink. PowerDirector. And in here, you've got your versions of PowerDirector. You can go into each one. And you can go ahead and go to cache, figure out which files you want to delete. Or you can go ahead and go to these cache files here for videos. If you got stuff in here, you can go ahead and delete those if you want to. Go ahead and go to images, same thing. You got all these files here. Might be some cleanup that you can do here to help free up some space as well. If this pie chart is telling you you don't have space, another thing that you could do is check your partitions to make sure that they're correct. Now, if the available drive space and the use space add up to an amount that's smaller than the size of your drive, you probably got a partition issue. Basically, your drive is broken into a few partitions so that each part of the drive can be accessed for certain activities. Now, checking your drive partition is really simple. All you got to do is go down to the search bar and type in disk management. And you'll see here it says create and format hard disk partitions. You click on that. Now, the main drive that I have everything going to, as you saw before, is drive C. So if we click on drive C, we could see here that drive C is a partition of 953.27 gigabytes. So it's good to go, it's healthy. Now, the thing is, my disk actually has three partitions. It has one for recovery, and then it has another one for the system. Then it's giving me 900 for whatever I want to do, to boot up the drive, save data, yada, yada, yada. I don't have it here, but you might have an unallocated drive as part of disk one or disk zero, whatever disk you're using. So if you have something that's unallocated and it has a number in there, like let's say I had drive C had 400 gigs, and then I had another unallocated piece here that had 553.27 gigs. Then I would know, okay, if it's unallocated, it's not being used, and PowerDirector can't access it to save my files to, I have a small partition that's being unused. I need to go ahead and merge that partition with the rest of C. So if you have an unallocated drive, or you have a drive letter that has nothing on it, it's probably was a problem that happened at some point when your drive was partitioned. Sometimes this can happen like when you update Windows and stuff like that. It creates another partition by mistake. You might just have to go in there and fix that. Now, there are plenty of videos on YouTube that show you how to extend your partition. Search it on YouTube and you'll find some videos to get that done. Now, once your drive issues are all sorted out, you can make the best use of whatever space you have on your hard drive by archiving your projects, which I show you how to do in this tutorial. Don't forget to smash my face to subscribe, hit me up with your comments, and drop me a like down below.